she gets her stream up, go ahead and give us a recap of last session while I go turn the AC down because I'm currently boiling. I'll be right back.
I'll let you know when I... Well, he needs to... Well, not ready yet, because I'm still trying to get the stream going. There's like a... I need to do sound check and... all that. Come on, hurry up. Why is it my stream showing up? Come on. Forget it. That's me banging on my iPad because I'm trying to get the stream to play because that helps. Hey, testing, check, check. Okay, y'all talk. Say stuff.
Just a small little army.
Last time on Dungeons and Dragons, we end up finding a mage and whooping his butt, making him cry, and I had to pay a fine back. Since we beat him up.
I was just trying to get us to talk for sound check, not for the actual recap.
Yeah. You committed assault.
Yeah.
Yes, I committed assault. I paid the fine.
Yeah, he had to pay a fine.
We saw the issue, turning our completed request, and we announced it out for the town of Thundertree. In order to go find the missing I forgot who that guy is. Like a missing friend of one of the townspeople.
Yeah.
Now we find ourselves in the midst of the town used to be called Thundertree.
And something that I realize is that we keep leaving the goblin dude back in Phandalin.
Like a missing friend of the townspeople.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we'll have. I mean, depending on how everything goes, we might have to unbat the man.
And you want to take him with you?
He was gonna help us find that castle. So if we want to go after that castle, we'll have to go back and get him. Okay.
So we came from the southern entrance that you mentioned, Chris, as you told last time.
Hmm.
So, we're just right here, so that's where we last stopped.
Alrighty. So, yes, you people are currently at the southern entrance of Thundertree. What you see is an old town overgrown with trees and heavy brush. It seems as if this particular town hasn't been occupied by any large number of people for quite a while, and one of you go ahead and roll me a perception check.
A perception check. We don't.
Will you roll me a perception check?
I have a +2, so let's see if that does anything. Why is my dice rolling so slow? It's like super slow. I'm refreshing.
Internet be slow today.
The internet slow.
Oh, I think I had turned off graphic acceleration. I have to turn it back on. But if I do that, I have to restart stupid Chrome, don't I? I was having some issues with Chrome constantly crashing, so I turned that off to see if it would fix it. Yeah, but my roll was crap, so I don't see anything. I'm looking at my shoes.
What was your roll? Four?
Four.
Vivi, you alive? You want to give us a perception check, or are you abstaining?
I'm... okay. Wait, am I out in the sun?
Yeah.
Yes, it is a relatively...
I have to relaunch Chrome.
Bright and sunny day.
Very annoying.
I have to plug that in. 12. All right. Well, Alistair is currently
looking at my shoes.
I don't know what she's currently staring into the sun, and
looking at my shoes.
But the rest of you notice that this house right over here seems to be in much better condition than all the other ones.
Which ones? I was in the middle of refreshing Chrome.
I don't think we can actually see the beings. No,
I'm not seeing it. Oh, okay.
Okay.
The one we're near. Okay.
This one right here. Seems to be in much better condition than all the other houses.
Well, let's knock on the door. Hello? Is anyone in?
Okay.
Are you going close?
What's up?
I'm still staring at my shoes. Okay. I'm staying back.
Don't worry, like, I'm probably gonna take the first full force of anything that finally comes out of that house, so don't worry. Hello? Is anyone in here? Does it appear like the door is like open a bit? Anything?
Sorry, I had to crawl under my desk or something. you knock on the door, and hang on, I gotta remove this. And the door swings open, and reveals dynamic lighting. Here we go.
How big are these squares?
Yeah, I gotta put them on the right layer. Reveals a white bearded human. And he says, "Who are you?"
Excuse us, sir. Do you happen to know someone from the town of Fanlin from a farm? They had sent us to look for someone that they said had gone up here a while back.
Who's asking?
Let's see.
I believe it's Keelan Alderley.
Killeen.
Oh, Killeen.
Right. And?
I don't remember if it's a girl or boy.
I say the name just appears to be.
This is D&D. Those foreign names.
Killeen wants us to come look for it. And I believe the person's name is Radoff.
Radoff.
Yep.
Would that be you, sir?
Yep.
Okay. Good news. Right. Radoff is good. Radoff is alive. Okay. Good news.
Well, that's good. Caitlin was just concerned that you haven't been seen in a while. So why are you out here in this old ruined town?
I don't like people.
That's understandable.
Can you be my friend?
Nope.
Okay. Well, since we're here, we didn't mean to ask you. Do you happen to know, like, an old shop that used to be owned by a woodworker family? That used to be around here?
Yep.
Then you might be able to point us in the right direction.
He he points you to the east. The east? Wait. Yeah, the east. That way.
Alright. Thank you, sir.
Just to the east. That's like the entire town. Okay. Okay.
All right, but is there anything we can help you with, sir? Anything at all?
People to the east, they annoy me. Take care of them, please.
Which part of the east?
And he slams the door in your face.
To the east, that's like the well, I mean, the immediate east is like right across the little way here, so I mean, we could start there, I guess.
I'll try talking to the door.
Okay.
We recently were charged with assault. We don't want to randomly just start hurting people again.
We weren't.
To go hit people.
I'm trying to say, so that it gives people the wrong idea. We made bad decisions, but we're not bad people.
He opens the door back up and he goes, hang on, I gotta make sure I'm on the right layer. He opens the door back up and goes, you smack people around?
You're good.
Well, we did guys who ended bad guys. If these guys around, if the people that you mentioned around here that's been doing some stuff, if you need to stop them with anything, we can't help
them. We punch for justice.
But you punch people who annoy me. Go punch people who annoy me.
Any bad people.
Alright.
I don't know. Black cloak. Masked.
They sound dark.
Alright. Maybe. Thank you, Radar. But do you know which part of the town where we might find those weird guys you mentioned?
What'd you say?
which part of the eastern part of town would we find those guys that you were mentioning that were bothering?
They're east of here. Southeast.
Southeast. Alright, thank you.
Okay.
Alright, guys. Well, listen, we're going to the southeastern part of town. And we can try to see if we can find the herbalist shop. The woodworker's family shop. Well, hopefully we don't get lost.
Alright, go away. And he slams the door in your face again.
Alright. Fall behind me, guys.
I'll go back up.
Where are we going?
We're going to the southeastern part of town, but we need to follow the road. Well, we probably have to follow the roadway instead of just trying to shamble our way through the trees and bushes.
Yeah, all I see here, let me move so I can see.
The description right off. A gaunt, white-bearded human who doesn't use two words when one word will do.
Sounds reasonable.
Literally
a description, so...
And I would like to point out, I think he didn't say they were in town.
Southeast.
But can always just still, examine where they've been.
Yes, which part of town? And
Southeast.
The southeast part of town.
So we
need to just search around the southeastern part of town. Look around, see what we can find.
Okay, so we're just walking down the road then, huh? Okay.
Follow me, my comrade.
Watch out for Beardy.
Say what?
What was that?
I was yelling through the door. Is there anything we should watch out for, Beardy? Anything?
Spiders.
Scary? Spiders.
Lions, zombies.
Oh, yay.
And, oh, yeah. Dragon.
Cool.
A dragon. Awesome. I'm doing a perception check to see if... Nope. I am going to choose new fake dice.
You realize that your left shoe is actually untied.
Noticed that something finally. I actually noticed that my shoes don't have shoelaces.
Your shoe is a driver, actually.
I perceive anything about my surroundings.
Nope.
Oh, one's had to look.
Yeah, I actually want to roll. Is there like any kind of movement in this town?
Oh, where are you?
Well, I mean, with
okay, the... he's here.
I just gotta see what your line of sight is. You do notice that some of the trees and bushes over here. Can you see this ping? Am I on the right layer?
Yeah, I can see it.
Okay. Over here, some of the trees and bushes, and over here, don't seem to be moving with the wind as they should.
Well, I can always... Tyron, do you sense anything?
Yeah, I actually, like, I kind of move a little bit hastily to you guys. And I, you know, whispering, I say, like, I think that our guy is right here and right there, so be careful.
Oh, we're going around there. So
this is east over here.
Yeah.
Let's try to follow the road. Okay. Explore the town a bit. But we should have asked where that dragon was located.
I think he was messing with us.
Hold up.
Sure.
I mean, hoping. Hopefully.
I mean, when someone mentions a
joke, you
think it can be a joke.
Sure. Man, a few words messing with us. Yeah.
I don't know, right?
I can wishfully think. I'm thinking that Chris is messing with us, but maybe not.
Wait, what? Huh? What?
I don't know. I think when someone says, "Oh yeah, there's a dragon around here," I don't think that's meant to be a joke. I do have to wonder.
Okay.
What would a dragon be doing all the way down here?
Who knows?
Alrighty, what is everybody's passive perception? Huh?
Passive perception of 12.
17.
Ooh,
12. Oh shoot.
Wait, is that wisdom?
That's basically
it's under senses.
4 plus 10.
Oh, yeah.
It's under senses.
12.
Mine's 12.
Alrighty. Vivi.
No.
Pin.
No.
You notice very slowly coming over this wall.
Which wall? Where are you pinging? I can't see.
Boom.
Oh, is that a Teresk? No.
You notice something coming over this wall here. Do you notify the rest of your group?
I just walk away.
Right.
You don't notify her?
I grunt and take out my crossbow. How about that?
Does anyone, so does our passive perception notice that she grunts and takes out her crossbow?
You don't. If she doesn't warn you, you don't notice. And, BB, go ahead and roll me a, everybody roll me initiative. Hang on, let me, ooh.
Don't forget to click on your token before you roll.
Yeah, click on your token before you roll.
Thanks, Vivi.
Oh, yeah, it's her fault the thing showed up. I am rolling drama. Terribly.
I'm sorry, you guys have horrible perception. Like,
I gotta delete all this.
If you notice something, you tell us. You'll just be like, I'm just
gonna move chicken shit. I can't be the brave one. Do you see how tiny I am?
Tell people. That doesn't mean they have to be the first one in line to fight. It just means it's just like, no.
I can't even see what that thing is.
I grunted.
Is that a big spider? What is that?
Oh.
Well, let's see here. Hold up. I gotta make sure to get all this correct.
Oh, that is a giant spider.
Yes, it is a giant spider.
I would rather it be a giant spider than a cockroach.
Either one's just as bad.
If it's giant, it's bad. bring more cockroaches. Yeah.
I would have just like put it away and be like, it's gross, I'm gonna shoot it, you know.
You will be able to act during the surprise round. That's what you get.
Oh.
Sorry, guys.
Because you didn't decide to.
Alrighty.
It rolled the highest initiative.
that's sad.
Yep. So Vivi, you get to act during the surprise round. The rest of you,
I'm looking at my shoes still, I guess.
Alrighty.
They're really cool shoes.
So basically, this spider over here, crawling over the top of the thing and goes for Ron. Ron, why don't you go ahead and let's see. I accidentally closed the stat block. Why did I do that? Anyway.
Okay. What should I roll?
Here. You are now webbed.
Oh.
I cannot see the
roll. Are you? Is that an attack? Is it an attack? Yeah, it is. That is an attack. It's actually a range attack, so.
I think maybe it has disadvantage. Maybe? Let me check.
Yeah, if it's that close, it has disadvantage. That's on me. So yeah, 18 to hit. Web.
Yep.
Alrighty. You're restrained by webbing. As an action, the restrained target can make a DC. Man, let me just pop it in here. Why didn't it? Hang on. Description show. Oh, there you go. Okay.
I can't see
his no damage, but you're restrained, and as an action, you can make a DC 12 strength check. Webbing can also be attacked and destroyed. AC 10, HP 5, vulnerability to fire, immunity to bludgeoning, poison, and psychic damage. Because webbing doesn't have a brain. So. Alrighty. Yeah. So, yeah. You are webbed.
Friend.
And that is the spider's ability. Pin, you're up.
I'll just go like skitter underneath a tree to go hide in the shade, and then. So if I'm in the shade of a tree, are you cool if you're saying that's enough shade to get me at a disadvantage for my attacks? Or do you want me to put on my frill girl?
You can go ahead and go right there, but I'm going to consider the brush difficult terrain. So you're going to use up extra movement. But yeah. If you're under the tree in the brush, you can.
Okie dokie. So I got to go ahead and be like, the spider, you guys.
Thanks.
Thanks, you didn't want us.
I'm gonna do, of course, my lovely pow pow. Shooty shooty. Oh, look! Oh,
is that a natural 20? Is that
nice?
Wow, nice.
Go ahead and roll damage.
And then I guess it's doubled on.
Yeah, roll me another D8 and another 2D6.
Oh, then a
D6?
2D6. Oh, God.
Wow.
18, 16, 17,
20.
Oh, come on. That's sad.
Oh, wow. That's bad.
That's so... Okay. Well, it evened out, I guess.
No, you rolled 2 and then D6. So, no, roll me 2D6 because it just.
No space.
Like,
yeah.
The number. For two,
oh,
no space.
Okay.
Yeah, no space.
You can always use the dice roller at the
there's
left
a...
too. There's a little dice roller. Yeah, you see a little D20 over there?
Yeah.
There's like a dice roll on your
on the left.
Oh,
left.
And you can throw a scroll over two.
Oh, well, okay. So, yeah.
Three.
All right, so that's 17, 20, 28.
Bad spider.
Hey, it dead.
What? Okay, nice.
I did it.
One shot.
Hey, nice. Nah, it dead.
All right. I'll
all right. So I am not. Wait. I don't want to set Ron on fire. Okay.
I never said.
No, please.
I never said someone found said going to use your knife to come.
Oh. That's okay.
That's good and all, but it's still the spider's turn, and this one turns. Kind of
what?
Out
wait.
Of and it goes to attack. Let's say.
That is a really ugly spider.
It'll yeah, attack. It's gonna attack. Actually, it's gonna attack Alphonsito.
It's cute with its pokey ball sack face.
There's a 23 hit.
A 23, yeah, I think it does. Yeah.
That's a decent roll.
Does Alphonsito take poison damage?
I think not. Let me check.
Let's check. Yeah.
Damage immunity is poison. And condition immunity is poisoned. So
alrighty. Nope. So it only takes 10 piercing damage. So there you go.
Oh, okay. That's pretty good.
Alrighty. Ron. Actually, no. This is a surprise round. That's right. You guys don't act. Hey guys, guess what?
What?
Another spider.
This
one crawls over here.
Maybe.
And it goes. It's gonna web. Curtis. Why'd I close that stat block? Why do I keep doing that? Okay. Does a 16 hit you, Curtis?
No.
There it is.
16 does not hit. I have an 18 armor class.
Alrighty. 16 doesn't hit. So yeah, nothing happens. Alrighty. Next we got the dead spider. And Pin, you're back up.
Da 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 da. I'm gonna go through.
But I haven't even done anything yet. So you just restarted initiative, or what?
Yeah, it was a surprise round.
No, it was a surprise round. The only one who got to act was Pam because she was the only one who wasn't surprised.
Oh, okay.
And she didn't say anything with.
Well, she did this time. She said more friends.
Yeah.
I mean, we can tell. All right, we can tell since, you know.
Hey, you guys, you gonna do anything about the speedies? I'll go shoot the middle guy.
Okay.
Pew. Oh,
it's 16 hits.
Okay.
11 damage. Alrighty. It is not happy about getting shot. He goes, I don't know what a spider sounds like. So I've never listened to a spider talk.
Yeah.
Know.
I've never tried.
Things in the front and they're just clapping against each other.
Eek. I'm just thinking about Lord of the Rings right now and that. What's her name? That big spider.
Edja.
It actually will look over at you.
Who?
Pin. This one okay. That Pin just shot.
This one.
Look over at Pin. And I guess, does a 10 hit you, Pin?
I just giggle.
No. Okay. Alrighty, Ron, you are currently restrained. What do you do?
I heard something about fire, so I'm gonna do a strength check, right?
Strength check, yes, DC 12. Hey, you're out. Of course, okay, that nice. Is your action. That is your action. You still have a bonus action if you want to do something.
Yeah, I'm gonna reposition just a tiny bit over here. And as a bonus action, I activate Alfonsito. And Alfonsito is gonna smack this spider.
Smack the spider. That'll
call.
That hits. Go ahead and roll me damage.
7 damage.
Alrighty. This spider ain't looking great.
And that is my turn, yeah.
He's oozing a little bit. Alrighty.
He's oozing a little.
Alice, that you're up.
I'm gonna try flame on it.
Fire
it up.
Why am I rolling so bad? I need to change.
Your fur does.
I need to.
You go to throw the fire, and it hits the wall.
I need to change my fake dice. These fake dice are terrible.
The wall takes. How much damage does the wall take? We'll just say it takes.
It gets a little scorch mark on it.
Alrighty. Next giant spider. I need to roll d6 for him. That's a 1. That's a big fat nothing. He will move up here. And Curtis.
Yeah.
There's a 16. A 16 doesn't hit, right?
Yeah, 16 does not hit.
Alrighty. Next is your turn.
He's now in the line of my sight.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
No more fuzzy dice. Damage.
Crit, baby. Eight, and how much do I add to it?
Wait, are you using a longsword, right?
Yeah.
Are you using one-handed or two-handed?
Two-handed. Come on, I use a one-handed sword. And I have a shield of strength.
Then roll me 2d8. Because it keeps rolling a d10.
So roll 2d8.
Roll me 2d8.
And then add 4 to it, so that is 12.
Yeah. And,
And 12, okay. and then I'm going to use my special ability to use Divine Smite.
Okay.
To roll another 2d8. Oh, baby, 23.
Well, hold on, I'm not seeing them. What the hell is going on? I'm not seeing them get rolled in roll 20. Oh, there we go.
I'm not sure that one's not showing up.
No, it's not. It's my internet's being freaking weird for some reason.
Maybe.
Yeah, something like that. Okay. So yeah, 12, and then, oh yeah, okay, so, yeah, that's a dead spooter. You have killed the spooter.
The spooter man.
The spooter is now dead. Alrighty, Pin.
Finish him.
And that is the third dead spooter.
I did it.
The spooters are dead. You succeeded in killing the spooters. They only wanted to eat.
Well, they aren't eating me today. Well, since they came from this house, let's see what's inside.
Okay, you go ahead.
Can I milk its fangs to go pick out poison?
Yeah.
Poisons?
Give me. No, never mind. All right, so yeah, you can go ahead and try and milk the fangs of the spooters. Go ahead and give me a nature survival check.
I was actually thinking the same thing. Can I do the same thing?
Yep,
isn't it the survival. Fangs or the stinger that do that? Don't spiders have a stinger?
Don't fang.
No.
It's just fangs.
I know. The ones you're probably thinking of are scorpions.
Oh no, the survival.
No, I was thinking of Lord of the Rings.
No, you can do nature. You can do nature or survival. I said nature or survival.
Oh, okay. All right.
You both managed to get a small vial of poison.
Nice.
You can add that to your inventory. Alright, and
can I sense anything nearby?
You want to just look through the ruins here.
Yeah, like just look through the ruins. See if there's anything.
Yeah, go ahead and toss me a perception check. Nice. Alright, well you look around and this seems to be the ruins of some old store. You do notice that there is, by this tree here, a cocooned corpse of what seems to be a male elf. The body is shriveled up and sucked dry, and it seems to be wearing studded leather armor and has a short sword. It seems to be clothed in the garbs of an adventurer. This seems to be an unfortunate individual who managed to get trapped by the spider.
Mm.
You search his pack that he's wearing, and you manage to find a potion of healing.
A potion of healing.
Along with 23 GP
Hold and on.
35 SP.
23 GP and...
How much 35 energy? SP. Who needs the healing potion the most? Because I think right now we all have the same number. I would just say give the healing potion to whoever needs... Whoever...
The guy on the ground needs it.
Who?
The guy on the ground. He doesn't.
The guy on the ground needs it, yeah.
Yeah, the guy on the ground needs it, yeah.
Yeah.
Is there anywhere we can possibly bury him?
I mean, you're kind of in the middle of the woods. You can bury him wherever you want. Where do you want to bury him?
Well, take off his leather armor first, because we can sell that.
I grant him that that's a creative scorching. He's already been.
I'm sure he's wearing underclothes.
I'm flashing back to a Skyrim mission where. You talk to the ghost of a woman and you find her body. And if you take her, she goes, "Really? You took my armor? Could you leave me at least some dignity, please?"
I know, right? It's okay. Just rob the corpses.
You just had to take the armor?
The most I'd be willing to take with us is like the gold and the healing potion. We could use that. I'd rather not, but. Who needs any armor when you can put on themselves?
You broke up.
Who needs any armor when you can put on that they need to put on?
I think everyone's got armor that can use armor. Right?
Pretty much, but I could salvage that armor. Or we can sell that armor.
That's what I was saying.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We're not going to strip him naked, just the armor.
Yeah, I mean,
you can have his boots. You can keep them.
But still, I am looking at the spider's kitting. I think it's
chitin.
Say that chitin, yeah. And I am wondering, can I quote unquote skin the spiders
for materials?
I mean, if you want to skin the spiders, go ahead and give me another nature or survival check. Actually, let's go survival on it. Let's go survival. This is...
Oh, nice.
Nice. Alright,
I'm gonna let Alfonsito do the dirty work, to be honest. While I meant Alfonsito to repair the damage.
I'll just leave the guy. So I'll just bury the guy just like right outside the door right here.
Okay.
And I guess we can take his leather armor with us, I guess.
Who's taking the leather armor? Who's taking the potion?
I'll take the potion. I'll take the potion with me.
Okay. Who's taking the armor?
I am too busy right now, but I can take it.
here you go, Ron.
Okay, make sure to mark it.
I'm adding everything.
I'm gonna stack some stones up to make a little memory stone stack thing.
I already made the...
Okay, junk. Everything is junked.
Well, that's not right. Okay.
Now that he's buried, I should have thought of it before we buried him, but how long has he been dead? Out of curiosity, but it would be hard to tell on someone who has been sucked dry.
It's hard to tell because he's been sucked dry and pretty desiccated. And, judging by the desiccation, he could have been dead probably close to 100, 200 years, 300, 400. Who knows? So, he looks like a mummy.
Yeah, well, everyone would if they'd been sucked dry, right? So.
And we're not even in a desert, so that's weird.
Yeah, mummies in the middle of the forest.
Yeah, all right.
He wasn't came out the giant spiders. We'll just need to be a bit more careful.
So can I do another perception check? I'm switched dice. We'll see if these fake dice are even any better.
Okay. What are you doing a perception check for?
Any more potential enemies on our way? Whichever way we're heading, which way are we heading?
I was.
We're heading this way down here.
What was Vivi? What was Payne saying?
Okay, so, as we're at a crossroads, and we don't, I mean, because we probably want to eventually explore all this area, right? I suggest I want to try this thing with my lizard girl. So I can do a thing where I can go kind of catatonic and you see Pin just like kind of drop and like start drooling out of the mouth, just like looking like she's sleeping. But then the lizard girl just starts to dance around and like walk around and see the lizard girl go off somewhere. I should be able to talk though during this. I'll just be like,
yeah, you go blind, and basically whatever your senses you're using on the lizard girl replace senses. So if Pin can't, if you can see, seeing and hearing through the lizard girl's eyes and ears, and you can't see or hear as Pin.
Still speak though.
Yeah, you can still speak though.
Right now, my consciousness is in the lizard girl, and I can send the lizard girl out on a little mission. And if she gets stomped, whatever, I can replace her.
So it'll take you an hour.
She'll be quick. She's a little thing.
Okay.
So yeah.
No, it'll take you an hour to replace her. Is what I'm saying.
Oh yeah, that's fine. Whatever.
All right, you got the character sheet, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're gonna be rolling on the wizard character sheet. Ooh, that wisdom. Ooh.
I know.
We all know how is this gonna end.
You rolled a wisdom check? You rolled a wisdom check? I didn't see it.
No, they're just talking about the stats.
The user for once. I feel like it doesn't do anything.
Well, you use her as your little eye visor.
I guess. I could just use a hood or something else. I don't know.
Well, you can send her out as like a forward scout. I mean, yeah. You can. Go ahead and just tell me what you want to do, and I'll tell you what you need to roll.
Where do you guys want to go check out first?
This way.
I think I'm checking out this this building right here.
Check out the hut. All right.
Yeah. See if there's anything in there.
I mean, she is also really tiny too, so like. I'll just let her know.
Checking out that little hut there.
She'll just be like kind of creeping around.
Okay. Go ahead and give me a perception check as the lizard.
Oh gosh. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead roll a d20 and then minus one, I believe.
Yes. That is true. Ouch. The lizard notices that there are small little cockroaches running around, and she is very hungry.
I'm gonna stay away from that one.
Well, I will go over there. You guys just stay
that I'm not sure that is a wise thing for you to go alone.
Well, then you got to stay outside the building. If you hear anything, you know to move in. I literally had the most health out of everyone, so you guys just follow my lead.
Alrighty.
Unless we're trying to sneak up on somebody, but for the most part, I'm the tank.
Stomp the cockroaches while you're in there, unless the lizard's eating them.
She ate them.
Okay, good.
So, I go in here. Looking around, like, what type of home is this?
You notice, you go ahead and give me a tip.
That's a check. Alright.
Oh, actually, no. You don't need a perception check. That's right. Okay. You notice that this seems to be the herbalist shop that, Myrna was talking about.
Okay, the woodworkers.
Yes, this family. Ruined shop is cluttered with sagging storage shelves and broken furniture. Shards of glass and pieces of pottery glint in the weeds, and rubble next to rotted books and casts. Okay. Yeah, you notice that this seems to be the apothecary shop that Myrna was talking about, and when you go to check. In the wreckage of the store, you find a small case that contains a gold necklace with a fine emerald pendant.
All right, this must be what Myrna is looking for. It seems to be what Myrna was looking for. Let's keep it with us until we get back to town to let her know. I don't know, we found it. So, okay, so I'll put that down.
I'm writing it down. I'm doing it.
Thank you.
Can I do a perception check to see if there's anything salvageable? Because it's an herbalist shop, right?
Yeah, you can go ahead and give me a perception check and see if you can find anything worth taking.
My new dice are not doing it any better.
You notice that your right shoe is untied as well.
I don't have any shoelaces on my shoes.
Well, then your perception check is just that bad.
Well, it is untied by definition.
Well, that's at least we got two things done, but now we need to figure out who those strange people are. So I guess we need to keep searching. I see a building. I see a building over to I see one path over here leading to what seems to be an old building with a door missing. don't know if anything's in there. I see a building over here with a door.
I'm guessing Alfonsito could carry Bing, right?
Yeah.
Are you still using the lizard as your eyes, or are you?
Twin is pretty, really like fascinated and being a little tiny lizard, like tinier than she is right now.
Oh, okay. So yeah, she probably needs someone to help. Yeah.
You gotta pick me up and just like.
Okay. Yeah. Nice. So I carry Alfonsito carries Ping.
Sorry for the drool.
Nice. Okay, let's go.
The tiny lizard goes up onto your Elfacita's face and just licks it.
Does Pin get motion sickness?
I don't know. You'll find out. I can
Should we go this way?
We're gonna have to do one or the other at some point.
Oh, go down here.
The lizard girl confidently goes the other direction.
Alright, well, lizard girl goes the other direction. Lizard girl, roll me a perception check.
Perception. 11.
Okay, well, that's better than a 3 before?
3, yeah.
So, is there a setting on this fog of war that... Because right now, everything that's not in our line of sight is totally black, but that's even the stuff that we've already seen. Is it supposed to be that way?
Let me see if I can fix that.
Can I get sight on Alfonsito?
Can you guys see?
It's all the line of sight's black.
Okay. Is it working now? Explore mode?
Seems...
Should I refresh it?
It's working now.
Yeah, it's starting to do something.
It's starting to look better, yeah.
Refresh my page.
Yeah.
Okay, so,
I still can't see.
Lizard girl.
Well, due to where I'm at, I can't really see anything past. I can't see anything past the house.
Lizard girl, you notice that this ruin here, that it doesn't have much going on, but this house over here looks relatively intact. Looks like an old farmhouse. As for Curtis, what were you doing, Curtis?
I was
knocking on the door or something?
Well, I wasn't knocking on the door. I was going to see if I could hear anything. See if I could sense anything.
Alrighty,
how far does this divine sense go through the door?
Give me a perception.
Perception?
Divine sense does not work through the walls.
Yeah.
Well, you don't really hear much of anything coming in through the door, but you do notice, that there's a window right here, and you can look through the window.
All right. Hello. What do I see in there?
You see a few bodies laying on the floor.
He did mention there being zombies. Like, guys, I see some bodies on the floor. I don't want to jump to the conclusion, but they might be zombies.
Or undead. If the door's open, you might be able to use, like, detect undead or whatever now. Detect evil or whatever, right?
If I open the door slightly, can I detect it without anything, like, trying to jump up at me?
Does anyone have that detect evil, detect undead?
Yeah, I do. I have divine sense. It allows me to detect good and evil.
Well, detect good and evil and divine sense are two different things. And divine sense doesn't work through walls.
He was saying if you open the door a little.
Yeah, if you open up the door and you can, like... I think it may actually work through glass, because I think divine sense needs, is sort of a line of sight.
If you look through the
glass and you pop divine sense, you can probably tell whether they're.
How many bodies
they are with it? You pop divine sense?
Yes, divine.
Yeah, there's not. They're undead. They're undead.
All right, just leave that door closed.
We need to send these guys to rest.
Well, are you trying to sneak around and everything too?
We haven't been doing any stealth checks or anything.
Have you been doing stealth? You haven't been doing stealth checks, have you?
No.
Nope. Oh no.
No stealth checks. Yay! Didn't think about that, did you? Okay. Well, zombies hear you clank, clank, clanking out there.
Ah, shoot.
Clank, clank, clank. Clank, clank. And they get up and they start beating on the door.
Well,
anyone got any more oil?
I think I do.
Don't forget to click on your token.
Pen, time, pen, get back in your body.
No, I get a snap on it.
Wow. It's a zero initiative for that, Tommy.
Good.
It's an 8.
Okay.
And a 5.
I didn't know you could roll a 0. Zombies, is it because of -1?
Well, if you have a -2 modifier.
Oh, -2.
You can roll 0. You can even roll a negative. You can roll a -1. All right, Alice, what is your dex score?
+3, 16.
Mine is +1, it's 12.
And alrighty. And okay.
There's three of them from time to open the door and start to shank them.
Well, I don't think you're supposed to move now because the initiative's already started, so you can't move until it's your turn.
It's Alistat's turn.
Okay, so there, where's the door? Is that where he is?
No, I'm in front of the window.
You hear a bunch of beating on this door, Danny.
And there are no other windows? Is this window broken?
There's a window right here.
Is it broken?
No, it seems to be intact.
Can I come over here and ready in action to do burning hands if the door opens? Hello?
Yeah, you hold an action, you can do that.
So I'm going to ready an action for the door opens.
You just open the door and use burning hands.
I was just going to try to avoid that. But fine, I guess I'll open the door and do burning hands.
Wait,
is that under spells? Yeah. What?
Now here's the thing with burning hands. You're only going to probably be able to get that one zombie
right. So, because they're not in line of sight. I can't see. That's why.
Yeah.
Because the door's not open.
Yeah.
So it's not going to hit all of them if I do that. That's a waste.
Well, that's how this works. It's like you're gonna get. I really should import some
cones and stuff.
I was gonna say, just step away from the door and I'll just open it.
But no, you get it, it's 15 foot, right?
So where was I here? So
that one.
Was I here?
Yeah.
So I've moved 20. I have 20 more movement.
I was saying, you move back a bit.
Well, we don't have time to discuss what we're doing because it's like a 6-second turn.
Yeah, that's true.
So I was going to ready the action, but because I know from last time we fought zombies that I didn't do crap to them.
You can just stand back one and you should be able to hit them. Let's just say that.
Okay. So within the 6 seconds, he told me that my burning hands wouldn't hit them. So now I'm standing back. Okay.
I'm checking how this worked here. I'm double checking. Let me see here. I gotta load another. It's not loading. Shoot.
What are you trying to load?
Right, yeah, let's just. Because you hit the one square in front of you, and then it balloons out to 3 and then 5 squares.
Yeah.
That's how that should.
It's a cone. Yeah.
If it's 15, it's a 15-foot cone, right?
I think it's 15.
Yeah, that's how that should work.
15, yeah.
So that's your turn. You're holding an action.
I'm holding an action, I guess. But if it's not going to hit them, I would switch to punching. I would switch to holding an action to punch if Burning Hands isn't going to hit all of them.
No, it'll hit. No.
Okay.
No, it'll hit them.
Then I'll hold. Is it going to hit Curtis if Curtis is in the way?
Curtis.
Yes.
Because Curtis is standing right in front of me, then it's going to hit Curtis.
So, is it possible for me to just open the door from where I'm at, but just stay out of the way? Then when the zombies try to...
Yeah, if you want, you can use your action to...
I'm not going to...
You can open the door and jump out of the way for us. That.
Should I do that, or should I just stab the zombie through the window? Yeah, I'm gonna try to stab that. I'm gonna try to stab the zombie I see right here from the window.
What Curtis would do?
Teamwork.
What would Curtis do?
Teamwork makes the dream work.
I am a conquest
paladin. Everybody walk the dinosaur.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Again, what should I do? Should I just wait for them to bust out the door and then you attack them? Or should I just attack the zombie?
Well, I think within 6 seconds, we've already wasted our time. But,
Teamwork makes dream work.
But I'm waiting for the door to open so I can do Burning Hands. So whether or not you want to do that or stab something through the window is up to you. But then that keeps me from being able to do a potential amount of damage.
Door's flung wide open.
Okay, so.
Alrighty, Curtis flings the door open.
And so you're staying back. Okay.
Yep, he's staying back. We're just going to activate your ability here, then Curtis can do more shit. We'll say opening the door was just a free action.
Okay, so now my action is that. So it's a 13 dex save. For anything in the line of the cone.
Hey, guys. Guess what?
What?
Guess what? These guys aren't very good at dex saves.
Good. They're zombies.
Ooh. Okay, one gets it.
Is there an action to open this door so we can see?
That one got a nat 20 and it was an 18. Oh, shoot, sorry. I forgot. Oh. It's got a door on it.
Yeah.
Okay. Nope. The hand planning. There we go. So yeah, you, Curtis quickly opens the door and you shoot in fire like a flamethrower.
So it should have hit all of them except somebody got a nat 20. That was an undead acrobat, right?
So two of them hit the DCs, so they only take half damage.
Two, so it was an acrobat family. Okay.
But one of them, we'll say the ones behind them got damage. It's fine.
That makes more sense.
But the one right in front of the door got hit with a full brunt right in the face. And he's looking a bit crispy.
Crispy zombies. Crispy. Okay.
Alright.
And now Curtis gets to go.
We'll say you used about 10 feet of movement and a free action. What do you want to do now?
Flash the zombie that's in front of me. That's right in front of me. Flash.
All right. 22 hits. Roll damage.
All right. Roll a d8 and 4. That is 5, and that is 9. And
9 damage. Okay. That's it for you?
Yes, that'll be it.
Okay. This zombie, not looking great.
We've already learned these things have resilience, stupid zombies.
Yeah. Oh no, they have resilience to just staying dead unless mm-hmm. I use my magic on them.
Mm-hmm.
Thank goodness I have magic. I have radiant magic.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Next is Pin.
I need to find myself a radiant wakizashi.
Pin's gonna just snap out of the little frilled girl. What was it? Yeah. She's just gonna regain her consciousness again. Stumble off of Alfonsito and just go hop hop away. Kind of like tug at what is it? Curtis's feet and be like. And then she's just going to, I don't know, take out her rapier and then cast Green Flame Blade and hopefully be able to stab through the window of the guy that's right next to her.
Bah.
Green Flame Blade.
Yeah, you can stab through the window if you want. Okay. He's gonna have half cover though.
Okay. And I'm in full sun right now, so I'm gonna. Would this be a straight roll? Because he's technically.
Straight roll, yeah.
Alright.
No.
No.
And that's a crossbow. I thought you were using your.
Rapier.
Oh, my bad. It was the same kind of
thing. It would have been 7 anyway, modifier. Right?
Okay, yes, yeah, it would have been modifier. 7. Okay. No, so, yeah that doesn't.
Testing the crossbow.
Yeah, that doesn't, no, you, no, just, no.
Just, no. It's like you're barely able to reach the window.
Just, yeah, I'll look at my little girl and be like, please come. And I'll
that.
All right. And does she?
So she goes there. She's not even.
Okay. Alrighty, next is Ash Zombie. As zombie, it's gonna smack. 12 doesn't hit. I'm not even gonna bother. Next, Ron, you're up.
Yay. Okay, let's see. Is the door open or closed?
Open.
Which zombies are damaged?
All three. And hits, but this one is the most little one that's been most damaged right here. The one that's in the epicenter.
Okay, I'm actually gonna shoot the one in the middle. When I find my crossbow, okay. Here it is. 16.
16 hits.
Now, will these things
5 plus damage taken. Let's see. That'd be a... Oh, and it goes down. Because it sucks.
Nice.
Oh, like, rest in peace again.
Blah, zombie dead. Dead
zombie. With my bonus action, I'm gonna walk up on seat over here, and very, very graciously, he's just gonna smack through the window this guy in the face.
Alrighty.
Just bam.
Okay, yeah, an 18 hits even with half cover. Okay. Here we go. Ooh. Now it's that Ash Zombie's turn. And Ash Zombie out here is going to... He's going to look over at Pin. And he's going to go... Brains! And he's going to attack.
Brains?
Don't I technically get half cover as well?
Yeah.
And because this
but an 8 doesn't hit either. So. Yeah.
Wow.
I kind of do the Where's Elroy thing over the.
Brrr.
Like
brrr.
Sticking my nose brr. In there. Stare at him.
Brrr. Now, does a 19 hit?
To me?
Curtis.
Oh.
Yes, a 19 does hit.
Alright. You take. A grand total of 7 bludgeoning.
On it.
Alrighty. Alice, that. You just did 21 damage in one go. How do you feel?
Good, because I switched my fake dice to a different set of fake dice. And they actually rolled better.
Alrighty.
So... Since I am at a distance, I'm going to have to do something. I guess I could move over here, huh? Because I can still get to this one from here.
You can punch him.
I can get that one. Okay, I will do Wakasashi. Nat 20. So then how do we do... So it's 1d6 plus 3 first, right? And then roll another d6.
Yeah. 5. Alrighty.
So that's 10.
So yeah, you do, that's 10 damage, yeah.
And then I'm going to bonus action an unarmed strike. That one did not hit.
Well, so, actually, it does.
Oh, it does. Yay.
Yeah.
Okay.
That one hit. They have crap AC.
4.
Alrighty.
And I am trying to decide whether or not. So it's still up?
Yeah.
I'll use a key point. Do my other unarmed strike.
Alrighty.
I was gonna say to save it. I'll just attack.
13 hits. Roll damage.
But I wanna do damage. 4. That's
a lot of damage.
That's a lot of damage.
Okay, let's roll its con.
It just took a whole bunch of damage.
18 damage.
It's still up.
Not cool.
Especially for it.
You're next. Okay.
Alrighty. Curtis, you are up.
Sacred flame.
And that's not an AoE, is it? That's just a single target.
It's just a single target. Let's see. Deck save. Okay. Nope. He dead.
Cool. He dead?
Yep. He dead. Is that your turn? How are you doing?
Yeah, that's gonna be my turn.
Alrighty, Pin. You were up.
I'm gonna go ahead and just whip around the corner into the shaded room, hopefully. Right?
Alrighty.
And I go green from brave.
Green from brave.
Green from brave. Why are you using green from brave?
So I can rapier the face of the zombie.
Well, you don't need to use Green Flame Blade for that. You don't got the bonus damage on Green Flame Blade yet.
But it... He's only one there too, isn't he? Okay, never mind.
Yeah, there's only one. There's only one.
Well, it's for Flourish.
Okay. Alrighty, fine.
Whatever.
So is that volume better?
So, yeah, go ahead and roll damage. So, Pin comes in with sparkles around her, green sparkles around her sword. And she takes the rapier, whips it through the zombie. And the sparkles look very nice.
Yes. Okay. She sneezes.
And the zombie is still back up, is still up. Wait, hang on. Hold up. Wait, no, that's 18. 17? 17?
17.
22? Yep, zombie's still up. Ooh. Just made the DC.
I guess I'll
he's
just...
constitutional.
Where's my lizard?
Alrighty.
I can't grab my lizard through here.
Oh, you lost it. You need a pet. Drag him out. Drag him out.
Alright, is that your turn?
Yeah.
Run, you're up.
Okay, it's glossy time.
24, yep, that's 6 piercing damage. Okay, let's roll that con. Yep, zombie's dead.
Nice.
You did.
You have a bunch of zombie corpses lying in the
I investigate
doorway.
The room.
You investigate the room. Well, let me open my handy daddy thingy here. Use your perception check. Wow, okay. You see all. You see that the universe is composed of little tiny pieces of matter, each having its own element.
She like starts to float.
She starts to see space and time all together.
A third eye opens in her forehead, and all of that you realize that she has achieved oneness with the universe.
She transcended before me? Ah.
This is the way.
Okay.
Alistat considers whether or not to become Pin's disciple.
Okay, so... This appears to be some old smithy that has been abandoned a long time ago. Excuse me. There's a wide chimney and piles of rotted firewood. Let's see. There's a variety of old tools, tongs, bellows, hammers. There's a pair of iron anvils. But other than that, there really isn't much of anything.
Anything of use to a certain artificer?
Yep.
I pass along the message. I say exactly everything that you
want. Bonds, bellows, hammers, and a pair of anvils.
I joined an ambulance.
You take an ambulance.
You take an ambulance.
You, good sir, are over encumbered now.
Alfonsito takes the anvil.
Alfonsito is now over encumbered. Have fun moving it.
We're just going to delete them.
No bags of holding right now. Sorry.
Oh, too bad.
Can an artificer make a bag of holding?
Let's see here. I have perfect. Hold up. Before we do anything,
remember that the silk couch that I have is not a bag of holding.
How much does an ambil weight in the rules? I can't
if
even
you
find that.
Not a bag of holding. Would you know what it is? Or would you just have to stick your hand in it and think of items and see if things pop out?
The right one.
Yes. Stick your head in there and see what happens. You could transcend again.
There you go. I just posted something in the D&D chat. Thank you.
Huh?
In the D&D. Oh yeah, that one.
It's just 200 pounds. That's pretty light.
Okay. Here, I gotta. Alrighty, so what are you guys doing now?
So we haven't gone this way yet, right?
Yeah, we haven't gone that way. So, follow along, everyone. But, my pen, you said you know it's like a house over there.
Are we gonna do stealth checks this time?
Over there that looks a bit more intact.
Since we're like talking really loud and everything. Anyway.
I can go over and do like a proper stealth session. I'm kind of I can put the girl on my face, but she tends to get in my face a lot. It's kind of annoying. So.
The ostrich maneuver.
If I had advantage of stuff, I would have gotten the natural. I don't feel stealthy at all.
I'll stealth just for giggles.
Okay, I'm gonna do the same, actually.
Oh, I wish I had the second row.
Is everyone doing stealth checks, or... I need to do a stealth check.
No, I reloaded into the wrong game. Hold up.
Sudden planar shift into another dimension.
Yeah.
And,
I was looking for
cones and stuff.
Go back. Yeah, I was looking for cones and stuff in it. No, get me back. There we go. And I'm back.
So I made it 13, Ron a 10.
Wait, you have advantage on stealth checks? Pam?
No, just advantage.
So you roll a 13?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because
And an 8. Ooh, some beautiful stealth checks here, people.
Yeah, well, we've already been making a lot of noise.
Glorious. It's like, hey, we're going through the woods. Let's stomp on every dried twig we can find.
It's a damn dream.
Yeah.
Who needs to use a machete for brush? Let's use a chainsaw.
Exactly. Way more efficient.
I know, right? Okay. So basically, you guys go stomping through the woods, and
we're heading this way.
Yeah, you're heading this way, and You notice that this door right here suddenly closed.
Uh-oh.
Shut.
Ooh. The wind.
No, it's not the wind. I doubt the wind.
But it did close shut.
Yes,
it did. I'm gonna go around into the brush over here.
So let's not shoot first. I want to do...
Again, these might be the people that raid on Monday morning.
That's my specialty.
I want to do a perception check while we're in this thingy.
Okay. Wait. Are you going this way, Ken?
I'm gonna go in the brush. No, I'm gonna go around.
You going in the brush? No. You already went into the brush now. Hold up.
Uh-oh.
Hold up. There's gonna be a lot of stuff about to go down.
Give me 1 second.
Give me 1 second. I gotta check something here. Ooh, this is gonna be fun.
Find some friends.
Oh. Let's go ahead and give up. Hang on, I gotta make sure this is I don't want you guys seeing this.
Why not?
Yeah, that's perfect. Awesome. Okay.
Just stumble across Pandora's box. Okay. All right. Whatever works.
Oh, wow. They suck. Okay. Never mind. Okay. You're fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Totally didn't.
It's fine. It's totally fine. Nothing to see here.
Totally fine.
Okay.
You're totally fine. Okay. You're doing a perception check, right?
I am.
Go ahead and roll me a perception check.
These fake dice aren't any good either.
Wow. Okay. You finally managed to notice that your shoelaces—that your shoelaces
I don't have
exist.
Shoelaces.
You don't.
Yes.
Finally noticed that your shoelaces don't exist.
I'm probably going to do a perception check myself because I'm right in front of
you.
The
do
door.
A perception check and you notice. Wait. That's two. You notice,
I'm changing my fake dice
you
again.
You notice move, Curtis, you notice that there's movement in this house here? You can see it through this little window here.
Which
you
house?
Don't see much. This one right here. I am on the GM layer. you notice that there's movement in this house. Pin, you notice that there's movement in this brush over here.
Nice.
One of the things that he warns about zombies, weird people.
I thought he said blights or something.
He meant something about blights.
I look over at Ron and be like, shake my head, just like walk back around the corner over here. I point into the direction of the brush and be like, no nos.
Alfonsito got you. Don't worry.
Oh, hey, did you roll a stealth check for Alfonsito?
No.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no stealth check for Alfonsito, huh?
Uh-oh.
Go ahead and roll me a stealth check for Alfonsito. Let's see.
I guess I should do this.
Wow.
Work.
Wow. Alfonsito does a better stealth check
than anyone else. The big metal construct.
The big giant metal robot construct. That's literally just a tin can on legs.
He's very well oiled.
Making less noise than anybody else in the party.
That's awesome. What Ron did awesome. With that oil he bought the other day.
D&D people.
The man is right here.
Climbing on top of the ruins.
Oh no, guys! I know something
like
inside the house.
On top of the wall.
You notice something in the house? Okay. Are you yelling or whispering or doing hand signals?
Mostly to you, like someone's in the house. And I'm trying to move around so I can see the other.
So I'm gonna move back over here and. Tell them that. Did they already notice that there are people? Did they already notice who all noticed and who didn't notice that this happened over here?
That there was movement inside this house?
Yeah.
Curtis noticed that there's movement inside this house.
Then he just told me, so I went over here and I
that there was
told them that and Are they telling?
I actually point here.
And you tell me about that. So I'm going to come back over here and tell Curtis there's something over there too. We're gonna signal. We're gonna like point to my eyes and point in the direction whatever there's something is. So we're not making noise. Well, any more noise than all the twigs that and stones that we're kicking.
Can I sense anything evil in around within 60 feet? Since I'm out of the building.
Nope.
So is that just there's no role for that?
Nope, there's no role for that, but it's within line of sight, and it's a line of sight thing.
So if
and
you can't,
it does, and it doesn't detect evil. It just detects fiends, fey, undead, and celestials.
So none of those things.
Nope.
So it might be more spiders.
Could be.
Maybe
spiders that use doors.
Well, I mean, over in the bushes.
Oh, okay.
Well, Carl had sent him, I think he said that you can sense good and evil. Oh.
No, that's detective.
That's a different, a different one.
Oh, and Chris, can I climb the top of the ruins?
You can know the location of any celestial fiend or undead within 60 feet. Not even Fae. Wow, I thought it was Fae too. Okay.
Oh. Yeah, I thought something said Fae. Maybe that's detect good and evil.
I think that might be detect good and evil. Okay. Sorry, Pin. What would you say?
I was wondering if I could climb on top of the ruins. Just perch on top of there.
It's about... Let's say it's about 20 feet up. Go ahead and give me an athletics check.
My acrobatics to be very...
Remember, you're not doing flips up the wall. You're climbing the wall. Give me an athletics check.
Oh, that's
okay. Good. Yeah, you managed to get up the wall pretty easy, are now climbing on top of the wall. Now, if you're gonna run along the wall, I'll ask for an acrobatic check. You can hold Alt and not have your token snap to the grid.
Oh.
So if you wanna.
So if I wanna stand in the doorway, I can. Do that.
Yeah.
So I can just be in the doorway. Cool.
There you go. Yeah.
That way my eyes are on both of them.
Come here.
So I would guess that the immediate threat is whatever in the woods because whatever's in the house closed the door.
Again, he's on the bum again. Like my radar made me seem to be a little clues. Like these guys trying to hide themselves in here, like.
Are you yelling this to us you're standing there? So we know sign language because that's pretty detailed.
You at least know I'm basically telling you to point, like point to the house, point back to like the direction where Radoff is. Yeah, point like maybe the people.
It wasn't the zombies and the spiders that were making all the noise. Did he say people making noise? Was that what he was complaining about? Or things?
Yes. He said that there were people, like, he first told us that there, when I asked him, like, is there anything we can do? He said there's some people who have been coming around here doing something.
Okay.
And then he told us, and when Ben asked, is there anything we need to be careful of walking through the woods? And he mentioned lights. Giant spiders, zombies, and a giant dragon.
Well, I'm hoping that the dragon's way up in the top portion of the map and not right here.
Well, that has to be the smallest dragon I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
So, first, I motioned to Ron, like, come closer.
Can he see where you are?
Yeah,
at a wall.
Oh. All right. I am actually doing the same thing. Like, come here, guys.
Everyone's saying.
Dead link, coldest.
Yeah, I noticed.
There you go. Oh no, never mind. It's a poo link. There we go.
Oh, but the GIF is not even working. Okay, never mind.
It's not. It's just a picture.
Failed.
It's just a picture. Okay.
Check the D&D channel.
For my perspective, I want to be able to do like another look on the brush area to see if I can get a clearer view, if possible, of what's going on over there.
I have a question.
You're talking about the up here?
Yeah. Because I'm perched up now, so I should be able to see a bit better over the brush.
You wanna give it a bit of a look. I mean, you can do another. I'll give you a perception check with advantage. You're high up. You can see down.
Would it be normal unless? Actually, no. I'll have my lovely little guy on top of my face. That would be advantage.
Huh? Well, we'll give you normal then. Well, 19. So yeah. You notice very, very, they're quick, but the brush seems to be swarming with little creatures. Mm. You can't really tell what they are, but they seem to be blending in very well, and there seem to be a lot of them.
Mm.
And you guys thought I was joking about it, and you guys thought I was being paranoid. I say, let's just stick to the road.
I'll look to the Alice that, you know, and be like, a lot of creatures in brush.
So they don't seem to be like moving towards us or anything.
They're just some creatures going crazy in the brush.
So
they haven't noticed you yet.
Okay.
But maybe they might.
Are you rolling again for them?
He's rolling.
Wow. God, they suck. Anyway.
Okay. So how about we try to avoid the brush for now?
Mm-hmm.
So they don't notice us.
Go through the pathway. Because there'll be that should block off your view.
And I'm gonna come back in this little building here. If we come this way, maybe they won't notice us.
Pierre, can I see any through any windows in the building?
Which building? This one?
The one where the people closed off.
Yeah, there seems we went in like. I can see windows right here. We can see through them.
Is there windows?
Or no? Like, there's like little slots. I can see right here. Here and here, from what I can see. It might be windows.
I would have to jump to the other thing. See over there. I'm going to jump to the other portion. Can I do
that? Acrobatics check.
Yeah. Come on. Come on.
I'm blaming D&D Beyond.
You try to make this jump from one portion to another, and your foot slips, and you take a tumble.
Oh, no.
I try to catch her before she falls. Well, before she hurts.
I mean, yeah, give me a dex check.
Dexterity check.
13. Yeah, you manage to catch Pin before she hits the ground. You react pretty quick. But yeah. So yeah, you manage to catch Pin. Pin, you don't take 2d6.
2d6?
2d6. 20 foot high wall, that's 2d6.
I'm gonna go use the tree to go climb up this time. Climb up.
Alright, give me a athletics check for climbing the tree. Wow. Okay.
Pan is very athletic.
You making? Okay, so you climb the tree. You manage to climb the tree.
Can I see into the window? Probably not.
Yes, there is actually a window right here. You look through it?
Yes, I look through it.
Go ahead and give me a perception check.
Advantage or just regular?
I will do it regular. Because it's still sunny out, so well, okay. It doesn't matter. You notice, I'm the dynamic lighting thing there is a little weird, so you can't actually see through.
Yeah.
But I'll describe what you know. You notice, what looks like a horned mass, peeking out from one corner of the window, and then the back in.
A horned mask.
A horned mask.
So like a person with a mask on kind of thing. Some horny dude in there.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, she's not wrong, but she's not right.
So, not a very good description of what's going on right now. Okay.
He's just some guy peeking through the window at us. Horns. Horny.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Not entirely right, but not entirely wrong either.
Why are you even so perverted? He has horns.
I'm not a human.
I guess you're right. You're tall as them, so I guess you're.
I'm about the same height. Okay.
Here, okay? Calm down. I'm bad at that.
Can I do any kind of investigation or perception check while I'm in this thing here to see if there's anything here in this old ruin right here?
I mean, you can, but, I mean, you can. Yeah, if you want to. Yeah, go ahead.
What would I do?
Just, roll me an investigation check. Investigation. We'll do investigation.
2. I got a 3.
You investigate. And yeah,
this is annoying.
You discover that there seems to be a tree growing in this thing right here.
And
idea.
Yeah.
Why don't we close the exits and then burn?
Oh no, we can't just be
burn the guy. But did we not learn from last time?
That guy did before. He seemed secretive, but he didn't seem to be untrustworthy. And given the fact that we see guys with masks just staring out of a window,
he the annoyer quest giver, so he must be bad.
Uh huh.
Yeah, I don't know what he's doing, but given the fact that he's been warning his warnings about giant spiders, lights hiding in the woods, zombies, and sooner or later we're probably gonna come across that dragon. I don't think these guys are probably gonna be good people.
Well,
some weird furry vibes.
That's what you said about the dude with the zombies earlier, and then who wound up paying a fine for assault and battery. Yeah.
I may remind you, we wouldn't have gone to that fight if it wasn't for Ron and you messing up.
Oh, so it's our fault that you did assault and battery on this person. Because I was trying to help the person.
Ron's the one
who shot. And so we're going to argue about this now, outside of this house.
Children.
Then ease your way down and let's see if we can pry those windows open and get in. Just try to see if you can.
I'm gonna go around the back. I'm gonna go around the back.
The back of the house?
Yeah. I'm going to stealth mode.
Give me a stealth check.
Hopefully this time better. Yes.
Yes, that is better. Yes. Alrighty. Yeah, so you head around back.
The sea door?
You do see a door. There's a door right there.
All right.
What do you do with said door?
I'm gonna go put some caltrops right there at that door.
Just right in front of the door.
Right in front of the door.
All right. Well, you put caltrops right in front of the door.
And I could continue going around and see what else is going around over here.
You see a window right here?
I'm going to go peeky-weeky through the window.
Alrighty. Go peeking through the window. Go ahead and,
it's gonna be a...
Go ahead, You just see. And you see into the room. You notice that there seems to be a bunch of men all wearing the same sort of clothing. They have like black robes on and they're wearing some weird looking masks. Actually, hang on. Fucking. You see these.
So
they're all wearing the same weird looking mask, same black cloaks and everything. There seem to be like half a dozen guys in there. They're all avoiding the windows on and the doors on this side of the house.
Yeah, because that's so where they see us. Yeah.
You can see them plainly though. From
here. And so we know that these are, and she knows that these are cultists.
No, you guys don't know that they're called.
Pin.
No, she doesn't.
I mean,
that's just the name of the stat block. They could be okay. Anything. Like the stat block used for the mage at Old Owl Will was evil mage, but you know, let's see how well that turned out.
Yeah, we see how well that turned out.
Yeah.
Because I'm a magical little rogue now. I'm gonna point in the
direction. Who has transcended?
Yeah, I've transcended, and all of that, you're gonna hear a little whisper in your ear, and I'm gonna very quietly say, and a little whisper, so very quiet, and I'm stealthy at the same time, and hopefully they won't hear me through that. But I'm just gonna very quiet whisperly, hey, so there's like a bunch of really creepy guys in there, and they're a bunch of chicken shits because they're just hiding. They're not doing anything. They obviously know we're around. So
they know we're here.
These are the scary boys.
These are probably the... Okay, so then I'm going to relay what she said to these guys over here.
Also, there is a back door.
And there's the back door, yeah.
I have placed caltrops at the back door. Because haha.
And I'll just relay that. Because haha.
So they are so they kind of already know we're here. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm. They already know we're here because they closed the door and are hiding. Is that whispering in my head? I'm hearing voices say kill, kill.
Sure. I'm wasting my copper strings and stuff. My strings and copper.
I think our best option would be for us to take him to try to see if we can force him into reality.
So we're wanting to take the same approach that we took the last time, where you go in wanting being forceful and wanting to force answers out of people instead of having a conversation.
Sometimes you gotta force some answers out of people.
But we don't know that because we haven't actually talked to them yet.
Last time you did that, you got assault charges.
So Yep.
You don't have to tell anyone this time.
It's just no witnesses time.
There won't be any charges if there's no one left.
There's no witnesses. It's our word against nobody's.
I'm not saying we go over there and get murdered. I'm just saying go in there and get some answers out of these guys who they are and what they're doing here.
Mm-hmm.
And if they're just basically people who just happen to be who have the water to town, which doesn't really seem likely, I mean, like weird black mass on their face. Like, how often do you see those kind of people just high up in the ruins with all?
They could be cosplaying. You don't know.
They could be LARPing.
They could be LARPing right now.
We are far out.
We had this same conversation about the dude with at the well. We assumed, based on appearances.
And again, last time I recall, I was trying to speak to him, but Ron was like, "Forget it, I'm just gonna shoot them."
I suggest we smoke them out.
Smoke them out. Okay, so what are we doing? Are we gonna knock on the door and try to talk to them, or what? What are we doing?
Let's see if we can just try to sneak our way in. So,
breaking and entering. Okay.
Well, we don't know if that. I'm mainly concerned about that dragon here. We don't need.
I don't think there's a dragon inside the house, but maybe there is.
I'm not talking about inside the house. I'm talking about around the town.
Mm-hmm.
So lighting the building on fire is probably a bad idea.
VV transcended. They're actually us.
So, Ted, you can't keep an eye out. I'm gonna try to see if I can.
By the way, you can't really send messages to me. I can send them to you.
Yeah.
So
it's a one way.
I'm planning hanging out over here. I mean, I think with message, you can send a short thing back.
You might be able to respond, yeah.
Oh, it's like 25 words or something? So, what's the plan?
That's sending.
That's different.
Here, let me look it up.
Oh, yeah, they can reply in a whisper that only I can hear. So, if I'm sending them,
yeah, there you
they
go.
Can reply.
I'll just tell you.
Okay.
Just keep an eye out. Then go south. You go from behind on surprise.
So who is she sending a message to? Did she send a message to Curtis?
Well, I'll just say I'm sending messages to all you guys. Like, I'm just chiming in, just chirping in here and there.
So you can hear our conversation from the other side of the house right now?
No, I can hear whatever you respond back to me.
Okay.
So I'm hearing like bits and snippets.
Yeah.
Again, just keep your eyes out. Things go down, just be ready.
Alright, I'm just gonna go ahead and prop myself right next to the door. Like right around the
corner. My charisma is a -1, so I'm not gonna be able to help the situation.
Don't worry, I have a whole bunch of charisma. That's why I'm trying to talk down the guy at the well.
Oh, by the way, as soon as I'm come out this door, I'm shooting. Just saying.
You knock on the door.
Yeah.
There's no answer.
Hey, your pizza's here.
Pizza's here.
Brilliant.
Handygram.
Yes, what do you do now?
We would like to speak with you. No, you guys are in here. How do we know you guys are in here?
There's good pizza.
There's no response.
Ron, go to the southern window and see if you can pry it open.
Oh, okay, so we're just gonna force our way in now. Okay.
What is the window, actually?
Right down here.
There's a window right here, and a window right here.
But I mean, I don't wanna... Oh! I don't wanna, break in this house.
Why not?
They didn't do anything.
We just want to talk to them.
Yeah, all we're trying to do is talk to them.
Again,
we're not going to break in.
Again, we're dealing with some suspicious people that are hiding out in the ruins of a crime. I'll have it right. I'll be at least kept his family safe. And they see me wearing some weird stuff on under it. Again.
Mm-hmm.
All we're trying to do is talk. Figure out
We come in peace, huh? Like last time. We come in peace.
Exactly. We come in peace in order to kill you.
No, I say we come to figure out what you're doing here in this town.
Are you just saying that through the door?
Are we
yelling like outside of the door into the house?
Yeah, that's small. That's what I'm wondering.
Are we yelling right now?
I yell at the tongue. Whispering.
So they may not be able to hear us. Okay. How loud did you knock on the door?
I did not mean.
Charismatically.
You only knock once. I mean.
I'll just go by the door to see.
How do you know that they're not? They don't think that we're like part of the undead problem out here, and they're trying to hide from us.
Undead don't talk.
Undead, you don't talk.
Well, but I thought we weren't talking loud enough for them to hear us.
I play an undead character on Fridays that talk. He is a skeleton cowboy.
Yeah, and zombies can talk. They say brains.
So this is the movie zombies. This is fantasy zombies. Just
And they behave however the DM wants them to.
Blah blah blah.
Well, how do these zombies behave? Do they talk in actual human?
One of them did earlier.
Did they, Chris?
I don't remember.
One of them said something.
No.
Yeah, I remember him saying the zombie says brains and goes after somebody.
Yeah, that's right.
I don't remember who he went after, but he said brains.
That was Pin.
Not a zombie.
No, it was the zombie that said it.
The zombie said it. What about the skeleton rave, huh?
There was a rave, and we did talk to the skeletons in there. Yep. So, are we just going to stand around arguing again? Half of the game?
What are you going to do?
Just leave these guys
like... Question.
I'll go
like,
back up to the window over here and begin to see what they're doing in reaction to all this.
Yeah, what do you see over there? The warg or anything?
What do you see over there? Like, Penn, do you notice anything? Oh.
Wait, what did you say, cultist?
Like sensible or whatever it's called, should it work if they are evil? You know what I mean?
Sense evil and good. It's not specific.
It's not intention.
Not specifically evil, good or evil. It's more like different types of individuals and divine sense. And is it divine sense?
Divine sense is the one that he has.
That's theme slash
categories of things.
Yeah,
it can't tell your intent.
While they're doing all this, I'm gonna go peek back in the window to see what they're doing in reaction.
You go peek back through the window, and they're like, they got their heads together, and they're sort of whispering to each other. They seem to be discussing something.
Okay, I just dip back down and just like whisper really quietly. They're discussing shit.
Well, again, now will be our time to power move. Ron, go open the window in the south.
Offer
the window in the south.
Maybe we should offer something.
Vivi, you're the one with the best reputation in the past for being persuasive to people. Why don't I'm replying to that.
Negative one persuasion.
Yeah, persuasion. I have negative one.
Just find some random inventory and give it to them. Be like, hey, let's be friends. Let's make an adventure together.
I'm not proposing friendship until I know what their intentions are. I just want to speak to them, especially on why they're in this town.
Again, tip it. Typically, even the cops knock more than once.
They do. And they usually have a reason for entering, like a warrant or something, when they actually barge in, unless there is somebody in danger in the house, which we don't see that.
I mean, when we have suspicious black people in robes, and like black robes, and like weird things on their heads, I'm gonna knock again. I'm just telling them, like, just in case. We need to be prepared. So I knock on the door again. This time, somewhat louder.
Alright, do you say anything when you knock on the door?
Like, we would like to speak to you guys. We do not mean to cause any harm. We just want to understand who you guys are.
Roll me a persuasion check.
Okay.
You actually hear, Karis, you actually hear whispering, like loud whispering. You can't understand what they're saying, but you can hear like loud whispering in there.
Can I hear it from over here? Where am I at?
You can't really hear it either, but you do see that one of the cultists inside, he looks like to be in charge. He's kind of like seems to be relaying some orders or some commands to the other one. Curtis, you hear someone through the door saying, he says, "Who are you?"
My name is Curtis. I've heard some rumors about some suspicious people being around. I came by to see her. Came out to see who you guys are.
You hear the voice through the door say, "Well, from my perspective, you're the suspicious one."
I thought so.
What?
I didn't hear that. I didn't hear it.
I said, how so?
Well, you just come waltzing in here and you just start knocking on our door and asking all sorts of questions. You're the suspicious one here, not me. We've been here longer than you have.
How is knocking on our door suspicious?
You ask him this?
Yeah, honestly.
You ask? Okay, you ask if not. He's like, "All right. Well, if we were in a town, it wouldn't be. But we're in the middle of nowhere, in some ruins. There's a dragon. Why would you come knocking on someone's door like that?"
I'll whisper to Curtis. Ask, like, refer to the druid guy. Say that you're harassing him.
Damn what?
Wait,
because they've been harassing him, probably.
Just be truthful about why we were here. Not the treasure part, but the part where we were looking for somebody.
An associate of ours has told us about some vicious people around here, right where you guys are currently standing.
An associate you're talking about.
Well, we can talk about that if you're willing to speak to us openly.
don't know. You still seem kind of. You still seem a bit off. A bit off. And you hear someone inside, say something. Again, it sounds muffled because walls and doors and stuff like that. And he says, and finally, the voice inside says, all right, fine. And, the door opens. And you see, several men, wearing, black robes and weird looking masks. And they look at you and they go, and the one in front says, What is it you want to talk about? Make it quick. We have things to do.
You wanted to speak about why you guys are here. Is your leader in town? Why is your leader here?
And what business is it of yours, honestly?
Well, we just heard some weird rumors about people. We just want to make sure that nothing's going on around here. We've been hearing about some traveling bands of orcs traveling around. Well, it's also like there's a lot of strange things going on lately. See what you guys know. See if we could trade information.
A lot of strange things go on around here. I mean, you got the giant spiders, you got the zombies roaming around, you have the blights everywhere, literally everywhere. And oh yeah, did we mention the dragon?
Yeah.
So yeah, a lot of weird stuff going on. I mean, what do you expect? We live in a fantasy world.
Wow, that's meta.
Well, true, our world is not exactly the most normal of places. But hey.
It's normal for us, but, you know, not for, well, that's good. That scratches the ball. Let's get the conversation along here. Why should we tell you what we are doing? You are a strange person who just walked up to us and knocked on our door.
Well, what would you like in return? But we won't know that. We cannot speak with your leader.
Interesting proposition. How about... You know what? How about this? Why don't you come with us? The rest of you want to come along? You can if you want.
Come with you.
Come inside.
Inside?
Sure. Yeah. Sure.
So long as that we all.
I would rather stay outside.
Alright, if you want to stay outside, you can stay outside. Just the leader's inside. So if you want to talk to him, we gotta go further inside.
Can I do any kind of insight check?
I mean, yeah, you want to do an insight
to
check.
See
to
if they're trying to deceive us or trick us into some kind of trap or anything.
Coming inside?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, dude. You mean, yeah, go ahead.
Roll an
insight check.
Let me see.
And I also want to see if I... Is there, like, a history or religion check that I could do to see if I know what these people are?
My dog that I just got, he had just eaten some chocolate. And I think I need to take it to the vet to go have him puke up.
Ooh,
alright. How much chocolate?
It happened a while ago, but the boyfriend is, like, really worried. I guess people are freaking him out.
Is it dark or light?
Dark or milk. Okay, how much?
Milk.
It was like two pieces, like not even, it was like maybe 1 ounce, I think.
Are we talking like M&M size or?
They were about like, no, not M&M size. They were
like little.
It's 1 ounce of chocolate.
1 ounce of milk chocolate.
They're chocolates.
How big's the dog?
He's a bigger boy. He's like 40-50 pounds.
Is this the dog I saw that one time?
I don't know if I posted him anywhere, but I think he had puked up a bit, and then he was like, the boyfriend mentioned he had peed blood this morning.
Oh, when did he eat the chocolate?
It was last night.
If he's peeing blood, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah.
And take
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, that's something you want to take care of now.
Yeah, if he's puking pink blood, go ahead and take care of that. Yeah.
So sorry, I'm gonna go ahead and get this done because the vet should be open right now.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, call him first to make sure that. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'll talk to you guys later.
Okay.
If you guys get into a fight, I just be shooting and go pow pow.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm having a drop.
Okay. Okay. Alrighty.
So I was gonna do a religion check or something, history, religion, to see if I know what these people are.
Well, let's resolve the insight check first.
I rolled a 22.
Want to know if they were on the up and up and not trying to. I mean, these guys are sus as hell. They really okay. are. I mean, there are a bunch of guys wearing black robes and freaking weird masks in the middle of the woods.
Yeah.
They're suspicious.
Yeah.
But you can tell that them wanting to take it to their leader so you can talk to their leader, that they don't seem to be trying to trap you. You know?
Okay.
They don't seem to be trying to bring you into a trap further in. They seem to legitimately want to take you to their leader to talk to him.
And get a religion check or something to see if I know what they are.
Yeah, go ahead and do a religion check.
That was crap.
Yeah, like, same since I'm,
okay.
since I'm around as well. Let's see what I got.
Not as good, but you can tell that they seem to be part of some sort of cult. Not many mainstream religions have their members run around in black robes and weird looking masks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is definitely some cult activity. But other than that, you really can't tell. You're unfamiliar.
Okay.
So guys, you want to come play? Oh, you gotta stay outside.
Well, I'm not gonna let people go in alone, so.
I'm gonna send Alfonsito actually with him.
Are you staying outside?
Yep. Right about here, more or less.
Alright.
Actually, can I get a sight on Alfonsito? I'm supposed to have sight, but.
Oh, do you not have. Oh, he doesn't have. Oh, the token doesn't have sight.
Yeah, I think that is something you need to set up like in every map so I don't bother.
There you go.
Okay.
Yes, vision.
And there was a window here, I think?
Yeah, there's a window right here.
Right here?
Actually, give me a second. See if I can.
Help the first.
Gliding. Here. There you go. You can see in.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hello, Ping.
Yep. Alrighty, so you guys are going inside? Now, who's going inside? It's just, it's Curtis, Alfonsito, and Alistair.
Yeah, I'm not going to let him go in alone, so.
Okay, so it's Curtis, Alfonsito, and Alistair. Alrighty, so you guys are brought into the inner chamber.
Where are we going?
And these cultists, they're lined up against the walls here. Yes, Alfoncito, yes.
There's a whole bunch of them.
Go right, yeah. Go right there. And why do I keep... There we go. There you go. Alrighty, and you present yourselves to the cult here. And actually, we'll put... No! Stop that. Alrighty. So, as you walk in to this main room here, you see there are a bunch of cultists in here, and they're sort of looking around nervously, and they're looking at you suspiciously. You can see their furtive gazes through their dark masks, and this one right in front here. This one right here. Am I on the right layer? Yes, I am. He walks up to you and he says, "Hello, my name is Fabric. Who are you and what are you doing here? What do you want?"
Nice to meet you, Fabric. I'm Curtis. My name is Curtis. And these are some of my compatriots. We come here to ask some questions. We've just been searching around this place looking for an old associate. And when we came here, we met another one of our associates. Let us know about things that people connect to your group that's been wandering around here in Ruins of Thunder Tree. We just come to see what's going on. After all, it seems a little weird for someone to be just being inside of seemingly an old house and the ruins of a town, ruins of an old town.
Roll me a persuasion check.
That's still decent.
He looks at you thoughtfully and he says, "I really don't see what business it is of yours, what we're doing here, but I also don't see much harm in maybe telling you what we plan on doing." And one of the cultists walks up to him and whispers urgently in his ear. And the Fabric waves him off and says, "Enough. We've been holding off enough, and they seem capable. And they seem relatively capable." He turns to you, Curtis, and he says, "We have come to treat with the dragon who is staying in the ruins of the town. In the northern part of town."
It is a bit dangerous.
Yes. Which is why we are still here. We were discussing the best way to go about it, but we were discussing the best way to go about doing it. But it seems that the gods themselves have delivered us our answer.
What's the nature of this dragon? What kind of dragon?
He seems to be a young green dragon. And we wish to curry favor with him. However, we need the right sort of individual to approach him, otherwise we may... What's the word I'm looking for? Sorry, my brain's not working very well today. We may catch his ire. We don't want to do that. So,
what does this individual need to do?
Simply approach the dragon and give him our offering.
Offering.
He holds in his hand. He pulls out of a pocket, holds in his hand a small coffer. He says, "These. We are hoping to add these to his hoard and have him in order to appease him, and maybe, just maybe, we can." Find favor with him and find status among our fellows. Would you be willing to aid us with that?
I want to ask them about their religion, what they believe, who they worship.
We believe in the superiority of draconic kind. The masters of the airs and the elements. The ancients who once ruled these lands. We believe that they are superior beings.
Mm-hmm.
Deserving of worship.
Okay, so you just want to curry favor with this dragon?
Yes.
Do I know anything about, like, the dragons and, like, what the green dragons do or anything? Like, if they have any kind of certain sway towards good or evil or anything.
Roll me a nature check.
I check as well?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh. I got a 4. Curtis got a 7.
Curtis, you know that chromatic dragons, which a green dragon is a chromatic dragon, tend to lean towards evil alignments.
But tell me, if I want to know, have you already tried before when you came to this town? To approach.
Well, that is just the thing with such beings, is that first impressions are key. We have not yet approached the dragon because we do not want to offend it by sending someone who it would deem unworthy.
Do you worship all dragons, or?
Yeah, Curtis, you can roll an insight check, and he'll just... Fabric looks to you and says, "Yes, I mean, why wouldn't we?"
Okay, so they just worship all dragons, regardless. Okay.
You can assume so, yes. Insight check. What were you trying to insight?
I was insight, like, his intention. The intentions are benign, since I do know what green dragons are like.
I mean, he's telling the truth that first impressions are, you know, key to approaching a dragon, and seems to be being honest about that. The whole being worthy thing does seem a bit sus, though. In fact, let me see how much you managed to get. Yeah, when he says only those who are worthy should approach said dragon, in a first impression, it seems a little sus. Let's just say that.
What does it mean to be worthy?
To be worthy of... How should I put this? To be worthy of approaching such a grand and glorious being such as that.
How are we worthy? Does it have its own grading that we don't know, or what?
Well, they are mysterious beings and of unfathomable knowledge.
And if
truly we can only guess at what they desire and think.
Let's
see. Well, that is true. What happens if we aren't worthy?
Well, they are dragons, after all. I'm sure you can probably guess.
Yes.
Try to kill us.
Hey.
Okay. I would suggest we go discuss amongst ourselves whether or not we want to agree to take on this endeavor.
Yes. Can we have some time by ourselves? Discuss this first. Get back to you.
Please discuss. Talk it out amongst yourselves.
Before leaving, Alfonsito actually says, "When is this offering happening?"
Can Alfonsito even talk? I don't think Alfonsito can talk. Can he talk?
Let me copy and paste whatever. Oh no, he can understand, but he cannot speak. Okay, my bad. Okay.
Yeah. No, you're fine.
So Alfonsito stays silent.
Alrighty. So you guys want to go talk amongst yourselves? About whether or not you want to do this. Alright.
Okay, thank you. Give us a moment.
We will be back later on.
Take your time.
Okay. I guess we just walk out from the door.
Yeah, walk out the door.
I'm gonna come back over here in this little shelter here. Does anyone need... How's everyone doing? Does everyone need a rest?
I am at 21 HP.
Did you take damage?
When we were finding those zombies over there.
Like 7, stop complaining.
I'd rather like using my healing potion, especially if we do intend on taking on that dragon later. But I don't think we're strong enough to probably beat it, maybe.
Does everyone need a break right now? Do y'all need a 5-10 minute break?
Or... Yeah, I need a break because my brain. I'm
low on coffee.
I'm low on brain. So I'll be right back.
Okay, we will be right back. Going on break.
Hey, BRB.
No. Okay, I'm getting a phone call, just a second. Hello? In the middle of a play session, did you need something? Okay, hello? Are y'all there?
Yeah.
The ride showed up, so they're fine.
Hey guys, I'm probably gonna have to leave early. I got some... Well, the sun came up.
Well, that's like half the players, so... Well...
I guess I can try to get back to somewhere that's safe. See, we can speak with Rydon real quick for like any sanctuary.
No, I mean now would be a decent time because I mean you can discuss later like next step, what you guys. All
right.
Okay.
I mean, I guess. I guess that's that.
Okay.
Yeah, you too. I mean, half players down. I kind of wish we had more players, more willing to, you know,
join the campaign. Or
yeah, but run it.
But yeah, we don't want to do anything without enough players.
Right now is actually a pretty good call it. So, just call it. It's a little early, I know, but you know.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll call. Go ahead.
So I just made a note that we're regrouping to talk about whether or not we're going to take the quest.
The quest to treat the dragon?
Yeah.
So what do you think about it?
What do I think about it?
Go talk to the dragon?
Well...
You want to go talk to the dragon.
I'm fine trying to talk to the dragon if it's going to, like, get the cultists. The cultists are going to end up like getting killed probably if they go talk to the dragon. But I don't know. But that it's up to the team to discuss it, and they're not half of them aren't here, so did you figure out the mechanics for the healing potions and stuff?
Yeah, I'm trying to come up with something that's fun, but also realistic.
Yeah.
Especially when it comes to making magic kind of that potions, not so much. They're single use objects, but for like creating magical objects, but it's complicated. You don't want something that's going to take up too much time, too much downtime. You don't want something, you know.
Yeah, it's like, it takes like 2 weeks right now. Is that what you said? 1 week, 2 weeks?
Yeah, it's something insane. It's like 2 weeks for a regular healing potion. Like, that's kind of...
Yeah, I mean, that would make sense for, like, Superior and stuff like that. But then you also don't want it to be too easy to make healing potions.
Yeah.
Is there not something somebody else has come up with? Probably. There might be.
There might be, but I gotta look.
Hey, do you want to look at that right now, or is your brain dead?
My brain's dead. My brain is completely dead. I don't know what it is, but right about the time started hitting up the cultists for info, my brain
Yeah, okay.
I was trying to...
Were you expecting us to go try to kill all the cultists?
No, that wasn't it. It was like, I was expecting you to try to get in. Once you got in there, my brain just kind of went, bleh.
Hey, hey, cultist, are you just getting back?
Yep.
Curtis had to leave. So that's half the people gone.
Yeah.
So we're just chatting right now about mechanics and stuff. So we can't play anymore, really.
Okay, no problem.
I almost had to leave because... My niece's ride almost didn't show up on time, so I almost had to go take her to work.
Oh.
But they just showed up, so.
It's like blast.
Mm-hmm.
I think I'm gonna go and get sleep.
You have one session or two more today? Just one, right?
Well, I might need, if I'm like this by the time I get if I'm this bad when it comes game time later on tonight, I'm call it.
Yeah. Are you're the DM on this?
I mean, I code sort of
help. Oh, okay.
So they'll be able to get it. Okay, I'm wrong. My brain is just not wanting to cooperate.
Ugh. Yeah. Do you want a codium on this group or what? I mean, not that it matters because we are missing two players right now anyway, but...
I can handle it for the most part. It's module, so a lot of it... If I were doing a homebrew thing...
Yeah.
Rob.
Yeah.
But for now, I'm... Call it. I'm gonna go take a nap. Hope everything. Okay, everything. I'll talk to y'all later.
Okay.
Okay, no problem.
All right, y'all have a good day. Thanks for watching on Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.
Bye, Twitch.
Mm-hmm. All right, bye.